My name is Scott Carson. I'm a professor in the Smith School of Business in the strategy area. And my research interests are mainly in the area of governance. And in that sphere, I have three projects underway. The first is a broad healthcare project where I'm looking at national systems of governance in healthcare, most especially Canada, and have asked the question, if Canada were to have a healthcare strategy, what would it look like? What form would it take? How would it be structured? And how would it be governed? The question is important because in Canada, we have 14 strategies, 3 territorial governments, 10 provincial governments, and 1 federal government, but nothing that reflects an overarching perspective or an overarching strategy toward which all of the other strategic perspectives make a contribution. So my question now of national healthcare governance has resulted in the publication, or soon to be the publication, of our third of a trilogy on what a Canadian healthcare structure would look like. The second project looks at the connection between governments and corporations that governments establish, sometimes known as government business enterprises. The most well-known Canadian examples are what are called crown corporations. Governments, whether provincial, federal, or municipal, usually establish corporations to carry out public policy objectives, but in the process want those entities to be standalone or independent, unlike government agencies would be. So the governance structures of these enterprises tend to reflect similarity with the corporate governance structures, except for the unfortunate fact that governments have difficulty keeping their hands out of the entities which they establish to be independent, often because they're ambivalent about the public policy interests for which they are responsible and the operational independence of the entity. So the question is there some form of, some structure of governance that would promote keeping the government independent from and outside of the operating entity? And I have established what I think is what is called a bicameral governance structure that will do this. The third project looks at corporations, stock exchange listed corporations, and the role of the board of directors in approving very high levels of CEO compensation. Over the past decade, CEO compensation has been highly inflammatory because of the very significant absolute dollar amounts and the difference between CEO compensation and average workers. So boards of directors have been pilloried in the public eye for agreeing to such levels of corporate governance. So the question arises, are directors immoral in making the determinations that they do? Most studies look at the consequences of very high CEO compensation and focus on that and claim directors are irresponsible because of the inequities that come to exist with employees or social inequities as the result of disparities in public of very high differentials. My perspective is looking at the directors themselves and asking whether it is morally irresponsible for a director to approve such levels of compensation. So that is the third of the three governance studies that I'm engaged in. Well, typically in strategy, the major questions are, who should devise strategy? Should it be the CEO or the management group or some collaborative group of employees and directors and executives? So who should devise strategy? The second major area is what form should that strategy take? How should the analyses be done? What models should be used? What should go in the strategy? Should it include corporate responsibility, for example? And how should the strategy be implemented? How can the politics and the personal issues of employees and other members of the corporate community be harnessed in order for the strategy to be successfully implemented? And finally, what measures should be used for the determination of whether or not a strategy has been successful? Given that a candidate from economics or law or psychology, could be a PhD student or a researcher investigating these areas, the burning questions are really very broad. My particular interests are in corporate governance, where strategy is linked with the oversight of those strategic directions. Well, PhD programs are very important in universities in order to achieve a part of the research mission of the university. What makes the PhD program so important to us at the Smith School of Business is that the PhD students are natural sources of regeneration and excitement and participants in and developers of the academic and intellectual climate of the school. It's very, very important that PhD students be part of the community of scholarship.